The generation and distribution of electricity is one of the most significant components of modern society. It not only powers commerce and industry, it provides us with the comforts and standard of living we enjoy. The major source of the energy that is now used in the production of electricity is the burning of fossil fuels, and coal in particular. These sources are the fossilized remains of ancient vegetation, and they are present in the Earth's crust in finite quantities, while demands for them continue to increase along with the Earth's population and improvements in the standard of living. Coal, in particular, is still relatively abundant and is widely burned in power plants, even as massive accumulations of coal ash residues, which can contain toxic levels of minerals such as cadmium, arsenic, mercury, chromium, and lead, have become increasingly difficult to manage. One rational response for the future well-being of our descendants, as well as the planet, is to exploit the photosynthetic ability of plants to capture the sun's energy, and in particular, the ability of certain trees to store that energy in the form of fats and oils in seeds that can be harvested by mechanical means. Visitors to the tallowfuel.com website already know that the author is partial to the Chinese tallow tree because it grows so well in the southern states and produces such an abundance of energy-rich seeds. However, tallow trees have never been systematically cultivated for their seed production or harvested by mechanical means. To achieve this means applying modern methods of planting and managing large orchards and adapting existing tools and machinery to harvest this organic fuel source and prepare it for consumption. In addition, the admixture of tallow fuel with coal may require some modification of existing coal-fired furnaces, especially as the percentage of tallow fuel in the feedstock increases. The planting and management of tallow tree orchards would essentially follow examples set by the olive industry, where efficient methods of olive tree cultivation and harvesting have been established over time and have led to the profitable mass production of olive oil for human consumption. The creation of an orchard with well-defined hedgerows begins with the planting of saplings, such as this rather limp olive plant, into soil that is treated with lime if it is acidic, followed by a time-release fertilizer. Tying the young plant to a rigid stake is necessary to ensure that it grows upright and will present a straight and smooth trunk to any harvester that passes around it. Here, the sapling, also called a sucker, is planted inside double-drip irrigation lines. When the tree matures to the point that it will be harvested, it will be skirted to about 3 feet above the ground so that irrigation lines will not be disturbed as the harvester's catch frames and conveyor belts pass above them. More on this later. The plants are aligned along trellises and typically spaced about 12 feet apart to form a hedgerow. Rows are also spaced 16 to 18 feet apart to accommodate farm machinery. When olive trees are mature, they are sometimes pruned to a width of 6 feet as indicated here by this pomology assistant's outstretched arms, although white harvesters could straddle twice that width, and wider trees are often the rule. Several types of pruning devices are available and consist of arrays of circular saws mounted on adjustable beams. Here, the tops of trees, two rows at a time, are cropped to a uniform height. Vertically mounted saws crop trees to the desired width and keep the sides of the rows straight. And extendable saws, like this one, can be used to skirt the trees to a uniform height above the ground. The heart of a harvester is a picking head, like the one shown here, which is one of several experimental models used at the University of California at Davis for determining parameters that would minimize damage to olives that are mechanically harvested. This is important for olives that are intended for table service. However, bruising caused by mechanical harvesting is of less consequence for olives that are destined to be pressed for the oil. In use, the tines, or the rods of the picking head, are inserted into the canopy of the tree or shrub being harvested, where they agitate the branches and foliage sufficiently to dislodge the fruit while minimally damaging the plant itself. In operation, the picking head can be made to move up and down along the vertical axis, as well as rotate back and forth around the vertical axis. Moreover, the back and forth motion need not be linear, but can be circular or orbital as well. And in advanced harvesters, both the amplitude and frequency of all these motions are controllable by a combination of mechanical and electronic means. The motions used by the picking head depends on the type of fruit being picked and the branches to which it is attached. In addition, tines of various stiffness or shape can be used in picking heads to optimize the fruit yield and minimize plant damage. In actual practice, the most efficient harvesters employ two banks of multiple picking heads that sandwich trees between them and whose in and out motions are controlled by the harvester operator. This ability to move the picking assemblies together and apart as the harvester traverses a tree allows the tines to contact the outer portions of the canopy at its narrowest and widest points without impacting the larger interior branches. The fruit of the tallow tree is not unlike the fruit of the olive tree, but with the tallow tree, the desirable product is not what surrounds the seed, but the energy-rich seed itself. The success of the olive industry is the result of careful tree planting and efficient mechanical harvesting, and similar principles would apply to a developing tallow fuel industry. What follows are examples of several types of harvester that are available for this purpose. Here on this large olive orchard in California, a compact pass-through harvester removes fruit from the trees and transports it by means of conveyor belts over the adjoining hedgerow and into a collection cart that is pulled by a tractor. Although this harvester is relatively small, its overall operation is very efficient. On this olive farm in Georgia, a compact BEI harvester is driven over a row of olive trees aligned with a trellis. This harvester is designed to convey dislodged fruit onto the upper deck of the vehicle, where it is collected into crates or lugs by farm workers. Shown here is a large olive orchard in Australia with a Nelson harvester, which operates like other harvesters except that it is pulled by a tractor. Its principles of operation are the same as those of self-driven machines, but its open design allows its internal components to be readily observed. Inside, the picking heads can be seen to come together and apart, and this action is visible from the outside, where the housings with the motors that actuate the picking heads are driven together and apart. Running along the center of the harvester floor are segmented collection plates that are spring-loaded and which allow the trunk of a tree to pass through the harvester while leaving little space for fallen fruit to reach the ground. These collection plates divert the fruit to either side, where it lands on moving conveyor belts that transport the fruit to vertical bucket conveyors and ultimately to a horizontal conveyor that reaches over to the adjacent hedgerow and deposits it into a collection cart that is pulled alongside of the harvester by a second tractor. Here we see the base of an olive tree as it is approached by the harvester. Internally, the collection plates open and close around it as the tree passes through. This is more clearly seen from below. Inside the harvester, the tree passes between the picking heads where the motions of the beating tines dislodge the fruit from the branches. These motions must be adjusted for each type of fruit that is harvested in order to optimize yields while minimizing damage to the tree. In In a Portuguese olive orchard, a colossus harvester seemingly swallows the trees while it efficiently strips the olives from the branches and leaves the trees intact and nearly bare of fruit. The picked olives are then transported by means of conveyors to an adjacent collection cart that is pulled by a tractor. In a large olive orchard in Australia, a colossus harvester is getting ready to be used. Here, the frontal arms or guide poles of the harvester are being centered on the trunk of the tree it is approaching. This is easier to see when the tree that is being harvested is the last one in the hedgerow. This particular harvester has an array of catch frames on either side to catch as much as possible of the fruit that is dislodged and directed to the conveyor belts that lie below. An operator steers the harvester and controls the in and out movements of the two banks of picking heads as the harvester passes over the tree. Ultimately, the olives are conveyed through an overhead conduit and discharged into a collection cart located on the other side of the adjacent hedgerow. This oxbow harvester, operating in a California olive orchard, is an example of a compact, self-driven harvester equipped with a system of conveyor belts that discharges picked fruit over the adjacent hedgerow into a collection trailer pulled by a tractor. The bent tines of the picking heads is one example of the variety of shapes and motions that have been developed in an effort to maximize yields of picked fruit and minimize damage to trees. Olive trees for centuries have been cultivated to provide both food and oil for human use, and now we have an opportunity to provide for future energy needs by cultivating tallow trees as a renewable source of fuel that can substitute for coal, which itself is the remnant of vegetation dating back to the Paleozoic era. As finite resources of fossil fuels are gradually depleted owing to the demands of increasing population and higher standards of living, it is clear that the primary source of energy falling upon the earth must be trapped with ever-increasing efficiency. Because the Chinese tallow tree, with its energy trapping and storage mechanisms, is self-replicating and repairing, the fruit of this robust and renewable energy resource is a top contender as a replacement for coal, whose finite reserves will ultimately be depleted.
Keep on the sunny side, always on the sunny side. Keep on the sunny side of life. It will help us every day, it will brighten all our way if we keep on the sunny side of life. It will help us every day, it will brighten all our way if we keep